The Election Commission's logistic partner is asked to explain why materials used in the May polls were found abandoned in Cavite province. The boxes contained materials from about 10 cluster precincts from Tondo, Manila, where they were supposed to be brought to Laguna. The Comelec says prosecution is possible and payment may be withheld if issues are not resolved. The choice of F2 Logistics as Comelec's logistic partner was already questioned before the elections because of its links to a 2016 campaign donor of Philippine President Duterte.
Unang tanong, tama yung tanong mo, bakit yung kinuha? Hindi na alam niyo namang hindi yun ang kinukolekta ninyo. Bakit doon sa iba pa niyo bang pinuntahan, kinolekta niyo rin yung kahon na yun? So, gusto natin malaman mula sa kanila. Number two, baka naman sila mismo sinasabotahe ng kanilang mga empleyado.
The poll body meanwhile insists no votes were compromised as the boxes did not contain ballots, only what they call non-accountable documents.
Rest assured po, yung pong pinaka-importanteng dokumento, yung accountable forms po na official ballot, nandun po sa loob ng ballot box. Yung kalahati po ng official ballots na hindi nakuha, na hindi nagamit, nandun din po sa ballot box. At yung kalahati po nun, nasa aming custody. So makakaasa po kayo na talagang ito pong mga nandun dun sa mga box na yon, ito po yung mga sobra ng mga papel.
The Philippine Congress is all set to canvass the votes in the May 9th presidential and vice presidential races. Lawmakers hope to proclaim the country's next leaders this week. RJ Cruz reports.
It was dawn of Monday when about 167 ballot boxes containing certificates of canvass and 441 election returns were transported under heavy military and police guard from the Senate to the House of Representatives. Only 156 of the 173 expected certificates of canvass have been sent by the Senate to the House. At the House, these were stored under heavy guard at the newly renovated session hall. By 10 a.m. of Tuesday, the Senate and the House will convene a joint public session as the National Board of Canvassers for President and Vice President. One of their first acts, adopt the canvassing rules, then elect the 7 lawmakers from each chamber and 4 alternates from each chamber who will sit in the Joint Canvassing Committee, which will go through each of the 173 certificates from the provinces, cities, overseas voting posts, and local absentee voting. The certificates will be opened by the joint session before referring these to the committee. At the committee level, its members, along with the watchers and lawyers of the candidates, will check if the votes in the electronically transmitted certificates will match those in the physically transmitted certificates. If they match, the physically transmitted COC will be checked for due execution, the signatures and the thumb marks of the canvassing board, if it reflects the names of the candidates and their votes in figures, and if there are discrepancies. If there are no discrepancies, the result is admitted into the official tally. If there are discrepancies, the certificate may be deferred pending an explanation from the canvassing board and a ruling of the committee. Senators and congressmen vote separately to resolve conflicts. If there is a tie, the speaker and the Senate president will decide.
Pag na-convene na yun, magsa-start na tayo ng canvas, no? So iaano natin, i-open yung lahat ng COCs, i-compare siya, at saka titingnan yung if any may mga alterations siya. Normally doon kasi discrepancies na ano na makikita saan. Pag wala naman, so tuloy-tuloy lang. So, dapat magka-match yung ano yung sa electronically transmitted versus dun sa ano sa physically counted na mga ballots.
The COCs.
COCs, yes.
Once the committee is done with all the certificates, it will submit a committee report and resolution of both houses to the joint public session, which will then be the basis to proclaim the president-elect and the vice president-elect. By its own timetable, the joint committee will start at 2 in the afternoon of Tuesday, and it won't stop till the canvass is over, which is why it is possible the winners can be proclaimed this week. Speaker Lord Alan Velasco had already guaranteed to canvass the votes expeditiously and with transparency. The canvass is not expected to take long as the elections are automated. In 2016, Congress only took 3 days to canvass before proclaiming winners. In 2004, Congress proclaimed the winners with just 6 days to go before the turnover of power in what was the last manual election in Philippine history. On Monday, both the House and the Senate adopted the resolutions convening the joint public session by Tuesday. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Two government veterans are joining the cabinet of leading Philippine presidential candidate Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. Arsenio Balisacan, who chairs the Philippine Competition Commission, confirms he has accepted Marcos's offer for him to again lead the National Economic Development Authority. Balisacan previously headed the agency during the administration of then-President Benigno Aquino III. The Estrada administration's former Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma has also accepted his nomination to assume his previous post.
Nais kong bigyang din na wala akong dalang magic wand o quick fix solution sa mga issues na bumabatay o bumabalot sa ating sa larangan ng paggawa. Bigyan nyo kami ng pagkakataon na magkaroon ng konsultasyon sa mga sectors ng aming ng department.
Meanwhile, Marcos's team says Susan Toots Ople has agreed to head the Migrant Workers Department. It was also earlier announced that Marcos spokesman Vic Rodriguez will become executive secretary.
House Deputy Speaker and Cavite 7th District Representative Boying Remulla has been tapped to become the next Justice Secretary. Remulla had just recently won his re-election bid after running unopposed, but he will have to give up his congressional seat once he joins the cabinet. Katrina Domingo tells us more.
Presumptive President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. has chosen Cavite 7th District Representative Jesus Crispin Remulla, more known as Boying, to become his Justice Secretary.
I think he will be very good. He has, as you know, he has a great many years of experience in government, number one. And what many people do not know is that he's actually a very, very good lawyer. And so I think he will fit very nicely into the DOJ.
Remulla says he has been close with Marcos as early as 2007, when both of them worked as lawmakers in the House of Representatives. During the recent campaign, Remulla was among the politicians who actively endorsed Marcos's presidential bid.
Marami kaming naging conversation ni incoming President Marcos during the campaign. At that time, wala pa siya, I had no idea that I was being considered. The other specific things, we will talk about it later when there is the time to talk about it. Kasi marami talagang problema yung ating justice system na dapat itama natin, iwasto natin.
Remulla has yet to outline his priorities as Justice Secretary, saying he has the entire month of June to assess whether or not the DOJ, under his leadership, would pursue investigations on President Rodrigo Duterte's drug war, which has killed thousands of suspects, including minors.
That has to be decided properly given the facts and situation. Tingnan muna natin kung ano initial results. Kung talaga nag-i-indicate na kailangan pag-aralan pa, hindi gagawin natin. Eh, duty natin sa bansa yan.
Despite labeling some supporters of Vice President Lenny Robredo as either communist supporters or paid attendees in some Cavite rallies, Remulla says he is bent on enforcing a justice for all policy.
Karampe o kalaban, mayaman o mahirap, lahat ng basa't Pilipino, kahit na panyaga, kailangan irespeto natin ang kanilang karapatan.
Remulla and his clan, who are also involved in politics, successfully delivered some 1.12 million votes for Marcos in their bailiwick Cavite in the recently concluded national elections. When asked if the vote turnout for Marcos in Cavite was a factor in being given a cabinet post, Remulla says,
"I didn't apply for it. Parang he was hinting to me already, parang kahit wala pa yung boto, that he wanted me there."
Cavite's 7th District Representative post will be vacated as soon as Remulla assumes leadership at the DOJ. He ran unopposed and won his re-election bid as congressman.
I'm not worried about it very much. Kung meron mang special election or kung meron mang caretaker, it works well. But of course, I would prefer that na meron pa rin nakaupo sa distrito ko, because mahalaga yan sa pagsuporta sa pangulo natin.
So far, Remulla has yet to speak with current Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara. He says he needs to study the ins and outs of the DOJ so that the transition meeting can be more productive. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
Diplomats from the U.S. and three other countries meet with Philippine presidential frontrunner Bongbong Marcos, Japanese Ambassador Koshikawa Kazuhiko, South Korean Ambassador Kim In-chul, Indian Ambassador Shambhu Kumaran, and U.S. Charge d'Affaires Heather Varyava separately paid their courtesy calls to the presumptive president at his campaign headquarters in Mandaluyong City Monday. Marcos described their visit as a recognition of the new administration.
Maybe the comfortable margin that we enjoyed during the election has a part to play with that. Ang aking lang lagi pinapaalala sa kanila, sinasabi ko, palagay ko, sa pandemyang ito, ang recovery ng lahat natin ay hindi kakayanin ng kahit isang bansa, kahit gano'ng kayaman. Kailangan the partnerships will be the one that will bring us through. Keep the global economy at least as stable as is possible.
Among the topics discussed were security concerns and the possible extension of the visiting forces agreement between the Philippines and the U.S. Marcos also discussed with the South Korean envoy the possible revival of the Bataan nuclear power plant, which was built during the regime of his father, the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr.
Siyempre, security concerns, pinag-usapan namin the return or the re-signing or the extension of the VFA agreement and how it has to be redefined for the near future with the changing situation around the world, especially in our region.
President Rodrigo Duterte agrees the next administration should explore the possibility of using nuclear energy in the Philippines, especially amid rising oil prices. Oil prices have surged for more than 10 straight weeks as the Russia-Ukraine war affected the global crude oil supply since late February this year. But Duterte also echoed the warnings of experts that there are risks to using a nuclear power plant.
Total ang nag-umpisa naman ni Total kasi Marcos noon nagpagawa siya ng nuclear plant. Nuclear is forever. Kaya lang medyo ma-delikado to. Kagaya na nga sa Chernobyl ng Ukraine, nagkaroon ng leak